Yesterday, Epic released a device that I thought they weren't going to release to the general public for quite some time, I'm not going to lie. Of course, the release of this new device sparked some controversial debate over whether or not this was actually a good or bad thing for the Fortnite creative community. Which, if you think about it, I guess isn't that out of the ordinary, because there's pretty much always controversy circulating around this child's game we like to call Fortnite Creative. But either way, I have a few thoughts on it, so if you want to hear what I have to say, then stick around. First of all, before we get started, Mad Moods, great job on the hub. This is amazing, so well done. Hey everyone, this is Syntax, and today we are going to be looking at the newest device that was just recently added into Fortnite Creative, the Support a Creator device. I assume this device is available for everyone, even if you don't have a code because of how it works, but I'm not actually 100% sure, so if someone can fact check me on that, that'd be great. But if you check in your devices and it's not there, I guess it's just not available to you, so sucks to be you. But yeah, if you go into any one of your islands and you just look at devices, it's just kind of sitting right there. The initial cost of this thing is 1,035 memory. You can place it down, you can customize it, give it a different hue for the glow, like apple green. And then of course there's the area where you can put in whatever code you would like to support. Of course I'm gonna put in my own code. Be sure to use code SyntaxError when making daily purchases in the item shop. Hashtag ad, hashtag I'm a sellout, hashtag no shame. I'm just kidding, of course you don't have to do that if you want to, but whatever code you do type into here, I'm pretty sure when you press the button, it allows you to support that creator. Now, funny thing about this device, when you place it down, you can't actually, like, move it anywhere. Like, you can hear that I'm trying to place it down, but it doesn't let me move it. If I want to actually move this thing, I have to delete it and then, like, pick it up and place it down again, and then I have to rotate it and place it exactly where I want it, or I won't be able to, like, move it. Well, I can move it, I just have to delete it first. So make sure you place this thing precisely, or else you'll have to delete it if you want to move it. Either way, though, I do find it strange that they actually added this button into the game. I really didn't think this was gonna happen for, like, a long time. For those of you who are unaware, before they released this device to the general public like they did yesterday, your map had to actually fit a certain criteria to even get the device. Now, I don't know exactly what the specifics were for the criteria, but I'm pretty sure if you wanted to get this device, it either A, had to be like a really large open world experience where you saw the device once, like before you got into the actual game and then never saw it again, or it had to be a map that started immediately upon entry, so like as soon as you entered the map, the game was already started, and then you could have the button. But aside from those two criteria, I don't think anything else was required. But anyway, it seems like kind of a jump to go from having the map have to start right away or be a really large open world adventure to, okay, here you go, everybody can have it. Like, I'm not really sure what the thought process is, why they would release it to everybody when it was sort of strict criteria to begin with, but I mean, I guess we all have it now. That's pretty cool, right? There's absolutely nothing that can go wrong, right? Right? I've already seen exploits where people have gotten multiple support a creator device buttons in their maps, and like, obviously you can't duplicate this, so they're already finding bugs on how to duplicate this thing. I'm sure in a couple of days, Epic will release an announcement saying that there is an issue with the new support a creator device, and due to that issue, we will be temporarily disabling it. As they do with pretty much everything they release nowadays. But either way, it's in the game now, it's here. It might not be here to stay, but it's here right now, so that's pretty cool. I do want to really quickly talk about some of the reactions I've seen to the device, and then we'll just wrap the video up from there. It's always interesting to see how the community is going to react to what seems like such a detrimental change. Like I said earlier, before this device was released to the general public, your map had to fit a certain criteria to even have access to it. I'm sure with limited access to the device that was only compatible with particular game modes, like a Squid Game type game where as soon as you join, it starts right away, there was some exclusivity to it. It's almost as if the device had some sort of value that is greater than it is now. I mean, obviously, if you give everyone access to something, it's gonna have less value, but it just seems like there's a lot of people that are gonna, pardon my French, bitch about it? And I guess it really doesn't even seem like that. There are a lot of people bitching about it. There's already tons of people complaining, oh, I'm gonna lose all of my supporters. I'm not gonna get any supporters anymore. Yeah, that's not how it works, you know, right? Just because everybody has the device now doesn't mean you're gonna lose your supporters. All this device is really doing is making it easier for players to support who they want to support. Like, that's the whole point, I'm pretty sure. Now, should some people have access to this device? Do they deserve to have this device? No, no, they don't. And I mean, I don't want to name any names, you know? Because, you know, I'm not really, like, trying to personally attack anyone, but, like, there are just certain people that shouldn't have it. Either way, though, the device is out, and if everything goes to hell and people start abusing it or whatever the case may be, then Epic will just disable it until it's fixed like they always do. Whatever happens, I'm pretty sure the only purpose of the device is just to make it easier for the players who play the maps to support their favorite creators. Again, if it gets abused like it will, then they'll just disable it, do some workarounds, and then re-enable it, and everything will be fine. But yeah, that's my initial thoughts on the device. It does make it a lot easier for players to actually support their favorite creators, and I mean, it's much more convenient than the pregame lobby ever was. It's more noticeable, it's easier to interact with, and overall, I think it's going to improve the game as long as there's not too many people exploiting it. But anyway, that is everything I have for you guys today. I really do hope you enjoyed this video, and yeah, this has been Syntax. Later.